Let's get the show started. Now, this trade show is over 30 years old. It started in 1990. And since 31 years, actually, Hans Beckhoff is part. Hello, good morning, Hans. I calculate this. This is your 31st SPS trade show.
In 33 years.
Yeah, we were missing two years. Now, if you come to the booth and look around,
fantastic.
Is this still... Yeah, how is your feeling about this?
It's still a little bit the old feeling. So we have a look at the own products or the own booth, at all this exciting technology which we are presenting to our customers, this is always a good feeling. And it's different compared to 33 years ago. No? Because this was the second year of the SPS show at all. And it was a very small hall in Stuttgart. It was not in Nuremberg. And we had a very small booth, 6 times 6 meters, and now we have nearly 2,000 square meters. So it's a little bit of difference in between, but it's still the same competition, Olympic feeling. I'm always calling this the Olympics of automation technology, and we are part of it.
Yeah, and if I look around now to the Olympics, I mean, we have the different forums here.
Yeah, the software forum over there.
Behind us now is... TwinCAT also, now motion, it's amazing, isn't it?
Motion with all these standard types of motion, X-motion as we call it, with the XYS and X-planar and Atro, the robot. And over there is the I.O. part and our technology forum, which presents our used technology, so it's a perfect show.
One thing is always in common, and this is, it's about automation, and you yourself, you take a synonym, because you said it's the automation brain. So you compare the human evolution with the automation evolution for Beckhoff.
Yeah,
so
true,
why
do
you do that?
We will want to take some inspiration from the experience of Mother Nature.
Okay.
And over the millions of years of development, the result of this evolutionary genetic development is the human being. So we can look at the human being, how it's functioning. So how where is the intelligence, where is the control algorithm for the motion of the human being, and you know this, it's in the brain.
So
the brain is the central control organ of the human being, and Mother Nature decided to develop a lot of decentral motion, actoric, sensoric, but then it decided to bring all this information about these signals to the brain here in the brainstem and present it to the brain. And the brain then has a modular structure for motion, vision, talking, and intelligence and so on. And we do exactly the same with our TwinCAT philosophy. So TwinCAT is a software automation brain. And you look, such a robot like here, it's looking very similar to me.
Yeah, powerful, elegant shape.
And it needs a brain. And a robot has to move, so it needs a brain which can do movement. And it needs a brain, if we attach a camera to it, which can process vision. And we need a robot who can speak to us, so we can say start and stop to the robot. And we need a robot who has some artificial intelligence for developing some strategies. And all this is in TwinCAT. And so we can draw a map of functionality of TwinCAT, and beside this you can do a map of a human brain, and you'll see a lot of similarity. Therefore, automation brain is the way to go.
Nevertheless, on this trade show, people always discussing the difference between central and decentralized automation. Now, that goes along, or is this a separate?
It's going in parallel. So you see, such a robot needs a central control. Also a tool machine, because a lot of movements have to be correlated, and this is done in the best way that you have a central controller which is running a mathematical model of the complete movement, and not with a decentralized motion intelligence. So there Beckhoff is clearly positioned on the centralized part. But if you have a very big assembly line, then you can segment the assembly line into different sections, and then for sure it's maybe intelligent to give each segment its own control. And this is then a little bit decentralized. But if you look into the decentralized segment control, you find once again it's by principle a centralized functionality for this segment. So, and because Beckhoff is building big controls which can control the whole assembly line at once, and a lot of small controls which can be used for controlling one segment only. So it's up to our customers to select which way to go.
Okay, well, way to go. Let's go a little way. You just mentioned already one Beckhoff buzzword. This is TwinCAT.
Yeah.
Because TwinCAT is inside the brain, basically, and makes the control.
It's a software brain.
Yeah. It can do the main central, it can do the decentral. But TwinCAT is built 1969. So it's almost...
1996.
So it's almost 30 years old.
Yeah, that's true, yeah.
Is this still state of the art, or is TwinCAT just... old,
oh,
slow,
no, it's hard. No, it's the most modern control architecture you can think of, because it's completely software-based. All functionality we are delivering to our customers is realized in software packages, in small modules of software, and all this together is then installed on a standard operating system, which may be Windows, Linux, or BSD, or other ones. Yeah. And therefore, we have all the functionality in this one software package. And also, this is reflected, for instance, in the in our technology departments inside our company. So we have more than, or nearly 300 development engineers and product managers for TwinCAT. And they are building small groups of experts, about 20 to 30 groups. There may be experts for motion, experts for OPC UA communication, experts for TwinCAT, experts for loop control, for vision, and so on. And all these different groups contribute to this one package TwinCAT. And so we can deliver to our customers an integrated solution consisting out of the PLC functionality, the motion functionality, the vision functionality, and so on. And this is our leading philosophy, to give all the features you need for the automation of a machine in one package. This was true in 1996, and it's still true very much today.
Yeah. Now, when we started, there was one PC and there was one Windows, and we put TwinCAT on it. If I now take a look to the flexibility we have today, we have multiple hardware platforms in IP20, IP65. Is this variety necessary, or wouldn't be just one IPC enough?
No, it's the big advantage is that our basic know-how is coded in software only, and we can scale it onto different level of hardware platforms. This may be a high-end 64-core big iron PC, as we call them, for very demanding applications, but it may also be a 200-euro priced small controller, which is already capable of running the TwinCAT PLC, not the neural network or something like this, but the basic functions can be done, and so our customers can scale in terms of performance and in terms of price in a big, broad range.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I think this reflects also the variety of applications we have, because the variety of applications, our customers do everything you can imagine, from the really huge machine to a very small control application.
Yeah, it may be a small transportation band, and it may be a machine with where we control 150 axes with one PC.
Yeah.
So complicated battery production machines, for instance, the winders, they are quite complicated, has a lot of movement inside. And one of the advantages of Beckhoff technology is that we can build a mathematical model that we then have very clear functional principles after the machine is working, and this is very much accepted by our customers because it makes these big machines manageable.
Yeah. Now, when I now take a look into our TwinCAT forum, we just stop here, sneak around. Now,
it's already crowded.
Yeah. Behind us is the TwinCAT Highlight Forum, and we've built this out because there is a TwinCAT Highlight. So inside our TwinCAT development teams, one team created a new highlight. So what is the highlight of this trade show?
We have some highlights, but in the software area, it's for sure it's PLC++, our new PLC compiler, which opens up new dimensions of performance, and which allows our customer also to optimize their engineering and to optimize the performance of the machine.
Oh, perfect. And performance matters. This was our slogan already at the last trade show.
Speed matters,
So I think we hand over to Felix and to Bela, because they will talk about PLC++. Hans, thanks for the introduction today, and have a wonderful day.
Thanks.